Good morning, everybody. It is 5:42 a.m. Central Time on Monday, July 18th, 2016. And we are here on the Earthquake 3D live stream, and I want to make you aware of something that just happened here on the east coast of the United States. A very rare 4.3 earthquake struck at the Virginia, West Virginia, Kentucky border. And when I open up the coordinates on this, you're going to see they come from the Europeans. And the reason they come from the Europeans is because the USGS is not reporting the earthquake. Now, there's a reason the USGS is not reporting the earthquake, and it's entirely unscientific as to why. I'd like to draw your attention to the location in question. We'll get the coordinates from the USGS, and if you hear dings or rumbles as I'm talking, that's additional earthquakes striking in the Midwest. But we will grab the coordinates from the Europeans, put them in on Google Earth, and see what's there. I just did this. I already know what's there. I want to make this video to show you guys, and I want you guys, once I show you, I want you to make a big deal about this to the people on the East Coast, to the officials in Virginia, and to the USGS. This is the coordinates provided by the Europeans. The Europeans are the only ones we can rely on to get our earthquake information on the East Coast. But that's really suspect. When I look at the area and we take a look at the coordinates, we zoom in and you're going to see a bunch of roads here extending down to the south. Well, if we zoom in on the roads, what you're going to start to make out is that at the top of each one of these is a different oil or fracking operation, oil pumping and fracking operation. And you can make out the wells. Okay, you see these wells here? It's very obvious. They extend on for miles. We have a large oil and gas extraction operation right where the earthquake struck. This is the largest earthquake to strike on the East Coast since 2011. And it follows other 4.0 earthquakes which struck at the fracking operations to the west just a few days ago. Now, this is proof positive that earthquakes progress across distances, because this all started last week with a series of fours off the west coast that pushed to Nevada and caused 4.3s at Nevada's border, then caused 4.3s and 4.1s in Oklahoma at the fracking operations, now has caused 4.3 at the fracking and pumping operation in Virginia. I'm going to put this video out now, and I appreciate it if you'd share it with the people on the East Coast and let them know that there's always warning signs of coming movement that comes to the East Coast. You get a few days warning before you're going to be struck. And the larger the movement that strikes in the Midwest equals the larger the movement you're going to see on the East Coast within a few days' time. This defies all of modern day geology to some extent, all of seismic theory that the plates are moving in certain directions. Well, we see earthquakes progress in the opposite direction than what professionals tell us. Now, you were warned on the East Coast. You had a warning issued for you to watch for larger movement to strike this week. And I had someone come to my page after I issued the warning and tell me that earthquakes don't strike on the East Coast, and that if a large earthquake struck, they would give me a large sum of money. Well, looks like someone's going to have to pay up, because the largest earthquake to strike in the last 5 years has now struck, and as you can see on the screen one more time, here's the earthquake epicenter, and I better well put a place mark on it right now before anything happens or the earthquake gets deleted. I find it very strange that the USGS is not reporting this earthquake. They should have it on their map. The fact that they don't, it lets me know that there's some kind of political cronyism going on right now, that science isn't being done, but rather damage control is being done. Maybe even the consulting of the oil companies in question before letting the public know that an earthquake even occurred. I guarantee the people felt it in the region. Shallow enough to be felt, less than 10 kilometers deep, right on the flanks of the largest pumping operation in Virginia. There is no doubt about that. This goes on for miles, and it's at the top of every peak. Now, since I've been talking, a series of other earthquakes have struck around the planet. You can hear them dinging off, and this is happening over in the West Pacific. A swarm of fives is breaking out. Literally, four different 5.0 earthquakes have happened in the past 2 to 3 minutes since I've been talking. So that's over in the West Pacific. You hear that happening while I'm talking. But the activity on the East Coast. If you watched my update last night, you knew to watch the East Coast for movement, especially over the past couple days since all the force struck. So if you like the content here, we're doing a live stream that's available nonstop, 24/7, 365 days a year. And you can tune into the live stream to catch the most recent earthquakes whenever they strike. I do updates every night at 10 p.m., so you can tune in tonight at 10 p.m., and we'll be fully covering this earthquake and the other activity that strikes throughout the day today. I'd like to tell everybody listening, it's a good idea just to have an earthquake plan and be prepared just in case. You may never have to use the plan. Primarily, just know what you'll do when you're in a structure and an earthquake strikes. Make sure that you, your friends, your family, your loved ones, your coworkers, your employees, make sure that they know what to do when an earthquake strikes. Secondary to that, then comes the preparations, the food, the water, the transportation, communications, and possible self-defense, depending on where you are. But that's only for the large earthquakes, okay? We're talking right now about an earthquake that's the size of what struck in Oklahoma at the start of this year. And at the start of this year, chimneys were knocked down and facades were knocked off houses in Oklahoma by a shallow 4.3. So it's just worthy to note that those kind of things can happen to you on the East Coast, but you'll always have warning signs. We warned you. The warning was issued. You can talk to however many hundreds of people that were in the chat room last night when the warning was issued and the day before. So right now, it looks like there's just 83 people. I just find that very, very odd since it's 6:40 in the morning on the East Coast and the largest earthquake to strike on the East Coast just hit. Oh wait, that's right, nobody knows because it's not on the USGS website. Now this is wrong. This is scientific scandal that we have a 4.3 earthquake striking at a pumping operation on the East Coast and that our agencies responsible for reporting earthquakes didn't report it, aren't reporting it, still haven't reported it. And I'm going to take you over to their website one more time to prove to you that it's not there right now. Now, here's the information from the Europeans. Now, let's go to the USGS and hit refresh. Do you see any earthquakes listed on their real-time map here? Their latest earthquake in the U.S. is a 2.8 in Perry, Oklahoma. And this earthquake has now been up for nearly an hour. Now, you guys tell me, is there political cronyism going on inside of the USGS? Because if there is, they all need to be fired immediately. We expect science to be done at our scientific institutions and our public agencies tasked with reporting earthquakes. This shouldn't be a lecture, but I've got to say it. Please get this all the way out to every scientist you know, to everybody who you know who's into geophysics, seismic activity, even volcanism. Get it out to the world. Let everybody know that a 4.3 struck on the East Coast, and we caught the USGS not reporting it. Now, whether they report it late, I don't want to hear it. It's the East Coast. The Europeans reported it, and the only reason it's not on the map right now is because it's had a pumping operation. And that's got to stop. This has to stop. Denial in science has to stop, and I'm not going to settle for anything less than this going all the way to the top, and you guys are going to be the ones that have to do it. So I'm asking you, please, share it with the appropriate people who can get this information to the other appropriate people who can make a difference in this kind of stuff stopping in the future. We want to find out from the Europeans that we've got earthquakes on the East Coast, or do we want to find out from our public agencies? And do we care whether or not there's a pumping operation there? Is that going to prohibit us from finding out whether or not an earthquake happens there? I don't think it should. And I hope you guys agree with me. I hope you would want to know when the largest earthquake to strike on the East Coast in the last 5 years would happen, regardless of where it occurs, or the politics behind who owns where it occurred. It just proves that earthquakes transfer across a distance, and it proves that the man-made pumping operations are vulnerable when the pressure's coming. It proves everything I've told you for the last several years. So hang in there, guys. I want to just wish everybody much love and thank you for getting it this far. Okay? So I'll be back We'll keep watch throughout the day. If you guys have any comments or questions, you can put them down below this video because it's going to be posted on my main YouTube channel as soon as I'm done talking here on the live stream now.